Hi all, and welcome back to my statistical podcast. Today, we will cover chi-square in SPSS and related measures of association. The chi-square test will help us define whether the association is significant or not. If it is significant, then we will review the measure of association to get a sense of its strength. The association, as we said before, means that the two variables are related to the extent that knowing a person's attribute on one will help us guess the person's attribute on the other. Let's now go to SPSS and look at our data set GSS 2018 revised. We want to find out whether the two categorical variables, in this case marital status and gun law, are associated with each other. That is, that they are dependent or independent. The chi-square test will help and is appropriate for this task. Before, we looked at the crosstab for these two variables. We said that the crosstab looks like an intersection of two frequency tables. The crosstab between marital status and gun law did not show any particular significant differences, but let's see what the chi-square calculation has in store for us. Before we conduct the chi-square test, we're going to pose our hypotheses. The null hypothesis is that marital status is unrelated to gun law, or more specifically, there is no significant association between marital status and whether people favor or oppose gun permits. The alternative hypothesis is that there is a significant association between marital status and whether people favor or oppose gun permits. So here in SPSS, we're going to conduct the chi-square test by going to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Crosstabs. We've seen this path before. We're going to get both variables, gun law, and put it in the rows, and marital, as we said before, is the one that we think is the predictor, in the columns. Here, we're going to go to cells. Observe this selected by default. We're not going to select column as we did before in the other video, crosstabs in SPSS, but we're going to select expected. If you want to understand the results of a chi-square test, you've got to pay close attention to observed and expected counts. Put simply, the more these values differ from one another, the higher the chi-square score. The higher the chi-square score, the more likely it is to be significant, which means that the variables are dependent on each other, so an association exists. We click Continue here, and then we go to Statistics. We're going to select chi-square. The chi-square can tell you if the association is significant. However, it does not tell you how strongly these variables are associated with each other. For that, you need an effect size. Phi and Kramer's V will do the job. I'm going to select lambda as well, and I'll show you the difference later on in the output. Let's click Continue. We're going to click OK to bring the output. The case processing summary table just gives you the valid and missing cases, but the most important table after that is the cross-tabulation. So this shows you the categories of marital status, married, widowed, divorced, separated, never married, and the two rows, favor or oppose, attributes of the variable gun law. The observed counts are, as you can see here in the first row, 451 married people favor gun permits. However, the expected count are 459 people. So the expected count is what we would expect to see if the two variables were entirely independent of each other. That is, if there were no association between them. In that case, we would expect 459 married people to favor gun permits. However, we just see only 451. Alternatively, we would expect only 183 married people to oppose gun permits, but 191 oppose them. So we see more people that oppose gun permits than we would expect under the null hypothesis, and fewer people that favor gun permits as opposed to the one that we would expect. You can see the same things here in the other categories. However, these differences do not seem too big. And that is the important part here, the difference between the expected and the observed counts. So how does that translate with the chi-square test? The chi-square test must seem a little baffling at first, but it's not. The only thing that we need to see here is the chi-square value and the p-value. So you look at the Pearson chi-square row, the value is 4.169. That is kind of small. And that shows the small difference between the observed and the expected counts. Degrees of freedom 4, and the p-value is in the first row under the asymptotic significance two-tailed column, and that is 0.384. So that is a p-value that is greater than our alpha, 0.05. So the null hypothesis is retained. And we cannot accept the alternative hypothesis that there is a significant association between these two variables. Because the association is not significant, there is no point in going to look at the strength of the association. Therefore, phi and Kramer's V and lambda does not really make any sense to interpret. We're going to look at now another association. And instead of marital status as a predictor, we're going to replace that with political views. Let's see how political views affect someone's opinion in gun laws. So we do have this political recoded variable. We do have original poll views, but that has many more categories than we would like. So that is recoded into only three categories, liberal, moderate, and conservative. So let's do that chi-square test with the new association that we're trying to test. The null hypothesis remain the same. There is no significant association between political views and gun laws. And the alternative hypothesis is that there is a significant association between political views and the opinion on gun permits. So we go to analyze, descriptive statistics, cross tabs, and instead of marital, we're just going to get political views recoded. Bringing it to the columns, we're going to make sure that statistics has chi-square, phi, and Kramer's V and lambda, and cells have observed and expected, selected. So click continue, click OK. And now we have the cross tabs output. Political views recoded is in the columns, and it has three columns, liberal, moderate, and conservative. And we have the expected counts and the observed counts. There is a bigger difference between the observed and expected counts for the favor and oppose attributes. It tells us just by eyeballing this that there might be a larger chi-square score. And if the chi-square score is large, as we said, there may show that there is a significant association. So let's go to the chi-square test and look at this. The value of the chi-square is 70.6, and that is actually larger. With 2 degrees of freedom, it gives us a p-value of smaller than 0.001, and that is significant at almost any alpha level that we would choose. We chose 0.05. That p-value is smaller than 0.05. Therefore, we reject the null hypothesis. And because we reject the null hypothesis, we say that these two variables are not independent. They are dependent on each other. And therefore, we accept the alternative hypothesis that there is a significant relationship between these two. Now, because the relationship is significant, we're going to look at the strength. Both phi and Kramer's V value is 0.218. That is actually a sort of a moderate strength. It's not completely weak, but it's not also medium-sized. It's a moderate to medium-sized association between these two variables. Now let's go to the value of lambda. That is a directional measure. To understand lambda, we need to understand the concept of proportionate reduction of error, or PRE. Lambda operates on the PRE logic, and so let's introduce here quickly that logic through a thought experiment. Imagine you were a supervisor that will be interviewing 10 people. They are all outside your office waiting for you to call them. And let's say that one of your tasks is to guess the gender of each before they come in. If you know nothing about them, then there is really no useful strategy in guessing right. No way to make an educated guess. But suppose that you know from past experience that about 60% of all people that you interview in a day are women. This now would make the educated guess possible. You'd guess woman every time somebody comes in, and you'd be right 6 times and wrong 4 times. So you are right more often than you're wrong. However, you have their names at hand, you know, because you have their resumes as well. This should probably improve your guessing substantially. You'd guess a man for every Michael or Noah, and a woman for every Elizabeth or Sophie. Because some names are ambiguous, such as Pat or Sam, you probably wouldn't be completely accurate. So this improvement in correct outcomes can be calculated. Before, you were wrong 4 times, but with names, you were wrong only 2 times. You made 2 fewer mistakes, and this is an improvement of 50%, and this is the PRE. Going back to the lambda, we can see here in the first column value, the second row, favor or oppose gun permits is the dependent variable, and we treated that as the outcome, because knowing the political view would sort of affect or impact the opinion on favor or oppose gun permits. So when favor or oppose gun permits is the dependent variable or the outcome, we see a value of 0. So that is lambda. And that means that knowing political views actually does not help us at all in a more accurate representation or more accurate guessing of whether or not people favor or oppose gun permits. However, if we turn that around and make the opinion on gun law, favor or oppose gun permit, the predictor, then knowing that, we would improve our guessing on the political view of that particular participant by 0.061, and that is 6%, 6.1%. So we would improve the guessing on political view based on whether or not somebody favor or oppose gun permits, and not the other way around. So that is what lambda actually tells us here. So having covered the chi-square test, the cross-tabulation, directional measures, and measures of symmetry or effect size in cross-tabulation or association between categorical variables, we would suggest that you go on and look at some more association in this data set or other data sets, not only with nominal categorical variables, but also with ordinal categorical variables. This concludes this presentation. Thank you for watching.